Yes?
Serve you right after last night.
Yes, the butler.
There's nothing to explain. It was pretty obvious.
Just a moment, please. I was trying to make you jealous, if you must know. Well, go ahead, laugh.
I think I was probably trying to do the same.
I thought perhaps you'd fallen under his spell.
Yes, that was Sir Anthony Hopkins, the way he was, when the character he played was not so much Lecter as Lecher. Right, welcome back. Now, the biggest pop phenomenon of the last few years has got to be the Spice Girls. And I bet you're thinking there's not much we don't know about the Spice Girls. Well, I'm here to tell you that I was actually there when they made their very first national TV appearance. And it's for an item on Surprise Surprise.
Have you got a particular favourite you'd like to learn from?
Steve Penk.
Really? What's so special about Steve?
He's funny.
Well, I know Steve's in the building, and surprise, surprise, Sally. Who better to give you some tips of DJ trade than Mr. Steve Penk himself?
Sally!
Oh my God, lovely hair. And as you can see, Surprise Surprise shot the first wannabe video.
I've got Spice Girls here in the studio. Hello, guys!
Hey! Hi.
Would you like to introduce yourselves and tell us a little something about each of you?
All right, I'm Melanie C and I love football. Right.
And I'm Melanie B and I'm a northern nutter, so there you go.
And I'm Victoria and I like shopping.
Hi, I'm Jerry. I'm a major nutter, but there's meth in my madness.
Yeah. And I'm Emma and I love donuts, chocolate and pink.
Have any individual looks? Is that where the name Spice comes from? Variety is the spice of life.
Yeah, kind of. I mean, we're five completely different people here with different personalities, therefore we're going to wear different clothes. But it proves the point in a way, because you can wear different clothes and have a different personality but still get along together superbly.
Oh, yeah. But which of the girls gave up the chance of a massive career as a roller skater to be a pop star? Meanwhile, in this Emmerdale clip, guess who landed the prestigious role of swimmer in the background trying desperately to get noticed?
I want to be alone.
Yes, it was scary, and so was that swimming costume. Now, next. Another crop of homegrown talent making minor appearances before they landed some major roles. Starting with one of our most versatile actors taking a small part in the pantomime Mother Goose. But if you think, oh no, it's not, I promise you, oh yes it is.
Lupe, yes. Bring on your henchman.
Come on, henchman.
Lupe, it's painfully apparent to me that we are not going to get any rent.
No rent.
No rent. So seize the goods.
Seize the goods,
right,
what's
here we are.
Who will you
No, not her, you fool.
Can I help you, sir? This car. This is my father's car. I mean, where did you get it from? That's his number plate and everything. How long have you had it?
Not very long, but that's none of your business. This is a recent acquisition which is for sale.
But it's my dad's car.
Was, sir, perhaps. Was.
I'm all right. Just moving and slipping. Hitting, getting out of way.
Was that your great gift?
Yeah, that's mine. Last
turn. What about your punching power?
I'm not a really hard hitter, but I can hit when it comes to people who want to hit.
They've sent my sputum to Newcastle.
Newcastle? What for?
These tests.
I've never been to Newcastle. Never want to. I've never been to anywhere up there. Middlesbrough, Sunderland.
You haven't been to Sunderland? You've never been to Sunderland? Hold on. I've got a sister-in-law who lives in Sunderland. I must have been there 50 times. Don't try telling me anything about Sunderland.
Yes, madam, can I help you?
I want to report my husband missing.
Yes, ma'am. Could you give me a description, please, madam?
Oh, yeah, well, you see, he's tall, about 6'3", aged about 30. As a matter of fact, he looks a bit like that Robert Redford.
It's not
like that. Your dad's 65, short, bald and fat.
Yeah, but who the hell wants him back?
My final guest tonight started her career on shows like Good Evening Ulster and polished her considerable skills on LWT's long-running chat show Sunday Sunday, where she interviewed most of the biggest stars in the world. Tonight, instead of asking the questions, she's here to answer some. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the phenomenal Gloria Hunniford.
You clearly couldn't afford the Spice Girl, so I'm Old Spice, is that all right?
Gloria, I would describe you not only as beautiful, but multi-talented. I mean, radio, TV, but you started your career as a singer, didn't you?
I did, that's what I was going to be. I started in Northern Ireland when I was about 8. And it was, I hate to tell you, you were doing some black and white clips. This was actually pre-television. I shouldn't even admit it, but it was. It was in the country halls, you know, in and around Ireland. I got paid the big sum of 7 and 6 pence a night, which actually was quite a lot of money then. And that's what I was going to be until I got lured into broadcasting.
But didn't you have a hit record in 69?
I did. In fact, that's how I got into broadcasting. I made a record. Lulu actually took it to Eurovision. And it was one called Are You Ready for Love? So I made the Northern Ireland version, and a producer brought me in to be interviewed about it, you know, Lisburn housewife, you know, top of the charts. It meant nothing. I was number 8 on the Ulster charts.
That's right.
But anyway, it led me to broadcasting, so that was it.
Now, the thing that I can't understand, though, is this Julie Andrews phase you went through.
Well, what happened was I was actually employed to do a song a week into a show called Tea Time with Tommy, which was phenomenal in itself. And we had a producer over for a short spell of time, came over with his, you know, very London ideas, etc. And he thought that because we'd no budget whatsoever, that he would do production numbers. So I donned my little nurse's outfit and did my Julie Andrews number.
I think you should see it.
Here it comes.
Forget the boobs.
Honey bees that fetch the nectar from the flowers to the comb, never tire of ever buzzing to and fro. Because they take a little nip from every flower that they sip, and hence they find their task is not a grind. For a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down, the medicine go down, the medicine go down. Yes, a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down. In the most delightful, in the most delightful, in the most delightful.
Well, I never made it as a singer, but at least I tried. Didn't you love all that sort of pre-production stuff, you know, now you'll stand with your back to the camera and then you turn it around on cue. It was very funny.
Gloria,
it's awful, it's brilliant.
I'm not being kinky, but I've watched that, 30, 40 times. There's somebody in there that I spotted who's a little familiar. In fact, if we play it one more time, maybe you can tell us who the other familiar face is in here.
A robin feathering his nest is very little time.
Somebody that I think you know?
Absolutely. My daughter Karen. And of course, she was about, I guess, 6 or 7 then. And there's a little girl, actually, you can't quite see her at the moment, just on my left hand. And Karen fell in love with this little girl. We were doing the filming at an orphanage. And of course, Karen wanted to take this little girl home there and then.
Aww.
And you know, to this very day, she'll say to me, but you wouldn't let me take that little baby home.
She's never forgiven you.
Never forgiven me for it.
Now, those early days at Ulster TV must have been great fun. I mean, they looked like great fun.
They were actually. I mean, they were quite naive in some senses. And we used to get terribly, terribly excited if we had anybody from London. It was really sort of big deal, like the London director I was mentioning who came over to do that. And I remember on one occasion, you know, Van the Man, of course, Van Morrison had been away in America and had made great strides. But I always thought they were fab because do you remember when he was with them, they did that song,
yeah.
Gloria.
Yeah.
And of course, I always thought that, you know, that was my song.
It's written for
So when I got this chance to interview Van the Man from London, we thought that was terrific. And also even to have a live line going from Belfast to London was very exciting. So when we cut across to Van, he was sitting at a desk, don't know why, it was his record desk, and he had his feet up on the desk and he had a cup of tea. And during the whole interview, He just sat and picked the cream crackers out of his teeth. I asked him one question. I think I asked him one thing, and he went, yep. And that was it. And to this day, people say, do you remember that time Van Morrison, you know, just drank tea and picked the biscuits out of his teeth? So.
Now, listen, our team, brilliant researchers on this show, and I think we have the best team of researchers
you
on this
do.
Show, found a lot of funny clips from your Ulster days, but there is one that intrigues me, because I haven't got a clue what the hell is going on. So let me play you the clip first, and then you tell me what was going on. Have a look at this. Your nightie in a gasworks.
Oh, well, I was wearing a bit of curtain in my head, which is even more astonishing. It was a deserted gasworks, you're absolutely right. And I can only assume, I mean, you said you hadn't a clue what was going on. I don't think I had a clue either. I think it was for a Halloween special of some sort, and I was supposed to be very frightened. It probably was a dream sequence, but I certainly didn't get my equity card there either. Just as well somebody took me on as a broadcast, isn't it?
Now, listen,
can't sing, can't act.
Now listen, Sunday. Most people know you from the brilliant show Sunday, and you interviewed so many famous people. But I'm going to mention one name to you, Freddie Starr.
Oh, Freddie Starr kept my career going, I think, all during Sunday. It ran for 9 years, and I could probably give you about 10 clips of bizarre things that Freddie did. Things like bursting through sets and I mean, doing all his obscene, making all his noises and all his obscene gestures. But... On this particular occasion, he took me totally by surprise. Have a look.
Let's have a look. Speaking
into this microphone.
There's a microphone inside this.
Can you watch my lips?
Yeah, I'd like to kiss him.
You ready? Right? I was saying, you emerged the star of the royal variety.
You are beautiful. You are so beautiful. Oh, God.
Actually, that was after the time that he allegedly ate a hamster. You know that thing, Freddie Starr ate my hamster. And of course, he came on and he proceeded. You don't see all of it there, but he proceeded to eat the whole vase vasivores of roses. So hysterical.
Well, listen, isn't she a great sport? Please say thank you to Gloria Honey for everything.
Thank you.
As you've seen, we've dug up some extraordinary footage tonight, but we've now hit rock bottom. Our final compilation just goes to show that if you are in film or television, you can't hide your early work from us. Sorry, guys.
Man, you're single.
Here's Jonathan Ross carrying something for the weekend, it seems.
In case I get lucky. Or maybe two packets in case I get very lucky. I've got about 7 packets on me, so I'm hoping to get very lucky indeed. But this packet, I've got Mike, you might be interested in these, Tutti Frutti's. They come in bold banana flavour, luscious licorice, lusty lime, or for the real ravers, strawberry slurp. Please, I mean, this... it was a sock one, I thought, look. I mean, that kind of works, isn't it? That,
boy or girl?
Who, me?
Baby.
Well, my environment conscience is...
Who's this trying to look like Buffalo Bill in drag?
Jewellery. Old paper, cardboard, bottle tops, glass, and old beads. And this, a new version on the chastity belt. Jim Phillips, diamonds.
Now get your fat German backside out of my shop.
Or we smash this place to pieces.
You do that, boy, and I'll put a glass in your poxy face.
Jim means it, and the police were called 5 minutes ago.
You dirty soldier of the SS.
Get even hands off!
You hit my comrade.
Oh dear, that won't help her mood. Now, who's doing the impression of a walking haystack?
Half a bitter, please, Harold.
Forty-six, please.
I thought so. That's lager, Harold Rumpum.
Who's calling?
Morning, Steve. You're having a good time this morning.
Now, believe it or not, this was a decade before the very first Mr. Bean was made. Yes, it's old Snake Hips, super cool John Travolta shaking his bits in Grease. But he wasn't always so super or so cool. Somebody, please, let her in. And all together now, one more time. No, I'm kidding. Because that really is all we've got time for. We'll see you next time on The Way That They Were. I'm Steve Penk. Good night, everyone.